Going big.
But it beats the hell out of that hike.
It does.
The line of the bank, we just won to it.
One, two, three.
They may have heard stories about it, but they've never witnessed it.
We're on the hunt for just giant bass and untouched waters. You know, there's nothing like breaking into a pocket and, you know, lake, no matter what size it is, and fishing a body of water that you know that nobody's fished in the last 20, 30 years.
The reward, reaping the benefits of all your hard labor.
Absolutely.
And finally break in there. And you know that nobody's been in there, and waking up in the morning, throwing the tools out of the boat and putting the rods back in, and you know you're gonna go get bit first cast. There is no obstacle that's gonna stand in our way. We're gonna find a way to get into that water and fish it by boat. Untouched waters, virgin fish, and if it takes us tearing the boat up a little bit to get back there, we're gonna do it.
Right here, back around that tree up there.
Up to the left?
Yeah, up to the left right here, just follow this. The main point to basically recon and walking back through these mountains are to really get yourself a bearing on which way you're heading, so you're not doing twice the work, you know, cutting in the wrong direction, or maybe instead of making where the old channel makes a turn and you can go straight, you can cut yourself time off. I mean, anywhere you can make up time in that essence is great, because you know when you're doing these cuts, you know, 7-8 days.
A lot of work.
It's a lot of work. You know, if you can cut yourself off one day of work by going through something, you know, you're that much better. And you're not going to see that from the eye level of the water. You got to get up above it and get the bird's eye view of that channel.
This is it, dude.
Hey, this is absolutely holy grail, dude.
You see the holy grail of big ones.
Dude, just cutting the trail to the holy grail.
That's right.
This is the deal right here.
For sure, dude. All we got to do.
It's you like, can see it right there, yeah. Where it leaves the lake.
Exactly. So we cut the long way in rather than the short way, because if we go the short way in, it's going to go right to the river.
That's brutal. Yeah. You're going to get silt, traffic,
the whole thing, dude.
We're going to waste.
Come around the backside, take the long way in.
That's got to be the only way.
Yeah.
As a fisherman, I think it's one of the raddest things that you could ever experience.
You know, we take a lot of preparation and really planning out how we're gonna attack coming into these lakes, how we cut or don't cut.
Whoa.
will come in. That way the boat will kind of hold right here. We'll come in from underneath that lay down that way, and we'll start chopping from right here. That way we can pull the boat underneath this lay down. We can leave it here.
Totally disguise it.
Yeah,
no one
exactly.
Will know.
You're jumping in the current, the main river current, and you're swimming underneath the cane, and you're actually looking for the old river channel that runs into the backwater. You get in underneath that cane, it's pitch black. It's just crazy.
Go through this.
Dude.
Just go straight. We'll follow this wall. Ready?
This is brutal. All right, go.
This is it.
We're in the broad daylight, dude.
Yep, this is it. We're this. Look at that,
deep,
dude.
Too, dude. That's a channel.
Let's chop our way in here and get that boat so it's not poking out.
We got day one of the dirty mission. Got the truck full of tools. It's always nice on day one because you're still fresh. You're
no
all
cuts.
You're ready to go, excited about it. Come about day six, we're going to look a lot different.
Look like a couple cut up lobsters.
On this particular mission, the route that we chose to actually go the long route for the main fact that the shortest route would have cut from river to lake. If you open the top end of a lake, you're risking silting it in and also bringing it to the attention of the public that there's access now to a different body of water. So those are all things that we kind of have to keep in mind when we're planning our cut into these lakes. Is the thought that goes into, okay, how do we hide these lakes? How do we protect all the hard work we did? And a lot of times, it's a lot more work for us personally, but in the end, it's a much better decision for,
absolutely,
you know, to keep it kind of covered up.
Yeah. This is what it's all about right here. Remember the direction? Like I said, it's a flat cane. We should just be able to work them out. Channel chucking. Start dredging back. It's gonna be a mission.
This is a dirty mission. You know, depending on what the cut requires, you know, every lake and every cut we do is different. But as far as our attack plan on it, it seems to change a lot. A lot of times you'll have a guy running a chainsaw or a hedger or something. He'll be up front. You got another guy behind him pulling and clearing everything that he's cutting, pushing it up on the bank, getting it out of the way so that we can keep that boat moving forward, keep the progress going.
So as you're cutting, one of the things you want to make sure when you're doing is, you know, like Billy said, as you cut, one guy's in front cutting and the other guy's clearing. One thing you want to make sure is as you're clearing, everything goes over the side of the boat or in front of the boat, wherever you're at, so that boat can keep moving forward. The last thing you want is loading the backside of these channels up, where once you get in, you can't get back out. So a lot of times you'll see where we're cutting through these things, we're laying over the cane and creating spots where we can take all this extra debris and lay it over to the side so you can keep moving forward. It takes a lot of different tools throughout one cut. You know, you're not just dealing with, you know, flat cane, round cane, pencil toolies, you know, stuff like that. You're never really in one thing. You could be in a place where, you know, chainsaw and that's not gonna work. You're gonna need a pick and you're gonna have to pull clumps out, move them, separate them, and then you get into thick cane where you'll need a chainsaw or, you know, a hedge trimmer or something where it moves a lot of area really quick.
4 years ago, maybe five, this is where we got to. Look at that. Already marked bass. Two
big ones.
Two big bass.
Look at that.
Great. Another one coming at us. Aww. Look at that.
Look at that. That's what it's all about, folks. Right there. Right there. Reach in and grab that bad boy.
Whew. I'd like to put
that
it
that right the there is why we come back here. We haven't even got to the motherland yet. We're already marking fish. So, basically to give you guys a run back.
Oh, look at this.
Yeah. This is where we made it back to last time, where we cut back to. So, we know now that this is the wall. This is what we got to go through now, boys. This is it.
It seems like we're presented with just gnarly obstacles, and this one by far has been probably the most extreme. We hit what we refer to as the absolute wall of China. Straight up dry land, cane roots, something we had never dealt with before, and we really didn't have a way to attack it at first. It kind of threw us a curveball, you know? We got to it the first day, and once we kind of got it chopped down and really got a look at it, you know, we had to set back, and we got, you know, luckily we got there towards the end of that day, and we had to go back and put our brains together back at the house and figured we were going to take a chance and try and chainsaw some dry land.
We're tired, we're done with that day's work, and it's time to pack all our stuff up and try to get out and get home. And what happens? The water drops probably 18 inches
at least.
So instead of having a couple inches of water under the boat, now it's just mucky, nasty silt.
Dude, this is fucking joke.
It's like raw sewage, and it's up to your chest. It took us probably an hour and a half to 2 hours just to push the 150 feet back.
Just get out of there.
Back out of the channel.
What do you think, Buck Nasty? I think we had a good day. Made some solid progress. Should get back in there tomorrow, mop up the rest of the Great Wall.
I think it was a good day. I think, what is today?
Today's Thursday.
Today's Thursday, so yeah, I think...
Or Saturday we should be.
By Saturday.
Yeah.
Definitely. We'll probably be done late afternoon tomorrow. Saturday morning, come out and get to catch some fish.
Right on, man.
So heading into day two, already pretty exhausted. We knew that we were gonna have our work cut out for us. We had cleared off the wall of China, and
we really weren't sure what our tools were gonna work.
We weren't. We're coming out with new stuff, and we attacked the heck out of it. And we knew we had swam past it before that, crawled through it, swam past. And we knew that was pretty much our last obstacle. Yeah. That's what was holding us from the lake. And
at that point, there was really nothing that was gonna stop us.
There wasn't. We went beast mode on the wall of China. I mean.
Yeah, it was get through it and get it done.
Talk to me, Buck Nasty.
Well, we got through the wall. A few more clumps,
we'll be in the lake. Got about another 25 yards of this. Then it opens back up into another channel for about 50 yards or so. Then we figure out how to break into the lake. So.
We're taking a little lunch break, a little victory snack.
Yeah. And I don't know what time it is now, but sun's breaking over pretty good.
So after all the exhausting work of getting through the Wall of China and being just as happy as we could be to be through that thing,
full day on the Wall of China.
Full day, yeah, but it was probably one of the best feelings that even though that we couldn't fish that day, knowing that we made it in there and, you know, the next couple days were just going to be epic.
You can't even describe that feeling when you pull into that lake finally.
No.
Oh my God, there's the lake. Oh my God! Boys. Oh my God, dude.
So today's the day. It's the day that you finally get to throw the tools out of the boat and put the rods in it. The excitement, overwhelming. With that being said, you know, we get out here, we come out, and it's still a ton of work to get into the lake, but saying that it's worth it is an understatement because we know the reward that's about to
you
know what I mean? You're gonna go in there and you're gonna whack them.
It's like Christmas morning running downstairs. You know, when you get in the boat, you pack everything up and you break through, you push through that lake, and the first thing you do is pick up a rod, it's, you just can't wait.
So we're in the lake, it's go time, we start fishing, and I think Bucky was hooked up before I even got my line wet. And I don't know, a little bit into the morning, you can already, you get that feeling like, okay, this is gonna happen.
It's building to something.
Yes, this is real, the fish are here, it's everything that we imagined, and you're just whacking them. I think we caught 9 20-pound limits that day, just, I mean, from 6 hours of fishing?
6 hours of fishing and so many 4-pounders. I mean, I don't even know how many 4-pounders, 5-pounders we caught.
Old virgin fish, it's so bitchin'.
There's very few places that you go in and, you know, you go in there and utilize one of the funnest ways you like to fish at top water. I mean, you know, it's one of the funnest ways I like to fish, and I got to fish it all day long, bright bluebird skies day, and just top water all day long, just exploding on it all day long. I mean, there's nothing like it, you know. Most places you go, you get to fish the top water in the morning, the evening, and then it shuts down. You got to go to doing something else. But this lake was just all day top water bite.
Everything we hoped for.
Yeah.
We'll be right back.
Dirty Mission is my lifestyle. There's no obstacle that'll stand in my way just to get that bite.
A dirty mission is flat out what nobody else is willing to do to catch fish.
I'm Billy Skinner.
I'm Bucky Lay.
Why do I do it? Man, I do it for the rush. You finally cut your way back through after a week, you make one cast and you catch a 10 pounder, it just doesn't get any better than that.
Dude, we did it, bro.
It's just another dirty mission.